Welcome all, welcome to video lectures of Kulkarni's Academy of Mechanical Engineering. So for the new session 2021, we are starting our first batch on 24th of April. Registrations are open, and if you are really interested, you can just step in, we'll guide you perfectly. Now today I'm going to give the importance of Nusselt number in a heat transfer. What is Nusselt number and why do we calculate Nusselt number? What is the significance of Nusselt number? If the Nusselt number is more, what does it mean? If the Nusselt number is less, what does it mean? Let's see in detail. Chalo, before we go to this Nusselt number, let's see the mechanism of, modes of heat transfers, that is conduction, convection and radiation. Chalo. Now, in conduction, there is no motion, there is no gross movement, it is at the molecular level. That's why we call conduction as microscopic phenomenon, means they remain stationary. Let us assume these are molecules. I'll give you a simple example. Dekho idhar. Let us assume these are molecules and they are not moving. Chalo. Let us say this person has a book with him. There is a book with him. So I'll show you by different color. Let us say there is a book he is carrying. Now he wants to transfer this book to the last person. There are different modes of transfer. For example, he can stay here only. So he, without moving, he can transfer to second, from second to third, from third to fourth, fourth to fifth, and finally the book reaches this person. So this is in a stationary medium. So this is not moving at all, just vibrations. So it is dhakka lagke. So it is yaha se yaha, yaha se yaha, so yaha se yaha. It's moving like this. So this is at the microscopic level. So there is, it is occurring in a stationary medium. Stationary ka matlab rest. Now let us see the other mode. There are other, see, one mode is transferring of book from this to this. Here book ka matlab kya hai? Transferring of energy, heat from one position to the other position. So I am giving a simple example of transferring of book from one person to other person. Chalo. Now let's see the other way. Now, so look at my dear friends. Now I want to transfer this book which is with him. Yes, I want to transfer this to this person. This. Dekho, one is like this. Other is the same person is moving and carrying the book and giving it to him. Same person is moving and carrying that book and giving it to him. So that is the actual motion, or it is the gross movement of the system. Fluid flow plus heat transfer is convection. Actually, the system is very, this is flowing. While flowing and transferring, this is convection. Just observe which one is the faster mode. And the third mode, this is convection. What is convection? Actual motion and transferring. Then we have radiation. Just see, there is a book and I want to transfer here. Just throw it. There is no one to carry, no need for someone to carry. That's why there is no need of material medium in radiation. Just throw it. Matlab, electromagnetic waves, radiation in the form of electromagnetic waves is transferring. That is radiation. So now for a time being, let us keep radiation aside. Now we'll take care of conduction and convection. See, my dear students, I want to transfer this book from here to here. 1 second, dekhna. Please observe. We'll do two things. Simultaneously, let's do two things. Dekho, look at. Now, I'll remove this so that you will have a better understanding. Awesome. Chaliye. Look at, my dear students. Please observe. Idha dekhna. This is carrying, and let's see, both are occurring simultaneously. So which mode will occur faster? Let's see in detail. Dekho. Now, in conduction, from here, there is no motion. So we have to transfer from here to here, here to here, here to here, here to here. So in the meantime, let's see how this is carrying. And so final aim is transferring of this to this. Chalo dekhte hai. Idhar dekhna. देखो कंडक्शन इज स्टार्टिंग, कन्वेक्शन इज स्टार्टिंग. देखो एक बार. ओह माय गॉड. सो बिफोर इट कुड रीच हियर इट हैज रीच्ड. Before it could reach here, it has reached here. Means the convective mode is generally faster than conductive mode. Convective mode is faster than conductive mode because it itself is carrying. It itself is carrying. But here, here to here, here to here, here to here. Yeah, yahan se yahan aane tak, it has reached. So which mode of heat transfer is faster? Convective mode is faster. Now let us see, my dear students, the beauty of Nusselt number. Okay, before we go to this, I'll give you a simple explanation so that you can understand rather better. My dear students, let us take a container. There is some fluid. Okay, let us take same size of the container, no change at all, both are absolutely same, same dimensions, everything same, same fluid. What does it mean? If you have water here, we have water here, same thickness L, absolutely same. Now if you see perpendicular to the plane, actually it is like this. Perpendicular to the plane of the board, there is a width which I am not showing. So therefore, actually, this is the area which I am talking about. This is the area, but I am not showing. Chalo, koi baat nahi. You have understood rather clearly. Okay, fine. Now, my dear students, let us take this at 60 degrees centigrade. Let us take this at 30 degrees centigrade. Let us take the top at 30 and the top at 60. What does it mean? Just we have reverse. Idhar dekhna. So let this temperature be delta T. What do you mean by delta T? 60 minus 30. 60 minus 30 is delta T. Okay. Now, see what is happening in both the cases. Fluid is same. The answer is no. As this surface is hot, as this is hot surface, now the fluid molecules, dekho, which is in contact with this hot surface, they gain heat and the temperature increases. When the temperature of this fluid increases, when temperature increases, density decreases. When density decreases, it becomes lighter. When it becomes lighter, it moves up. Means, after absorbing heat, their temperature increases. When the temperature is increasing, they become lighter. When they become lighter, now they start moving up. Means, they are moving. This is physically, this is moving, and it is moving and carrying heat. It is moving and carrying heat. Therefore, here it is convection. Here it is convection. Now let us see what is happening here. The top surface is hot, so definitely hot. These fluid molecules, they gain heat, and this will become hotter. When it becomes hotter, its temperature increases. As the temperature increases, density decreases. When density decreases, it has to move up, but already it is at the top, it cannot move. But here there is a chance for this to move up, that's why it is actually flowing. So it is moving and carrying heat, therefore it is convection. But here it is already at the top, kyunki yahan ka temperature badh gaya. When the temperature is more, density will be less. When the density is less, it has to move up, but it cannot move up. Then what to do? There is no chance for this to move up because it is blocked. So by staying there only, it transfers heat. By staying there only, it transfers heat. So stationary medium. So this is nothing but conduction. This is nothing but what? Conduction. Very good, my dear students. So, kyunki it cannot move up, staying there only, it has to transfer. Therefore, the heat is transferred from top to bottom only in a stationary medium. Heat is transferred from low to bottom by actually flow of the fluid. So, this is convection and this is conduction. Let's calculate what is convective heat transfer. So, heat transfer by convection. What is convective heat transfer? HA delta T. We know Newton's law of cooling, HA delta T. A area, which area? Dekho, So perpendicular to the plane of the board, there is a width. So same area is also at the bottom. Us area se heat kya hai, upar ja raha hai. So HA, this is delta T, the temperature difference. Okay. Now let us go for heat transfer. In this case, it is conduction. And what is conductive equation? KA delta T by the thickness of between the two layers. Okay. K, where K, please note down, it is the thermal conductivity of the fluid, because conduction is occurring in the fluid, that you need to take care of. Fluid K area, okay, delta T, and this is the general equation. And what is the thickness? L. This is the heat transfer by conduction. It's a generalized equation which we'll be deriving in our regular course. So KA delta T by L, it is the heat transfer by conduction. But where is conduction occurring? It is occurring in fluid. That's why I wrote K of fluid. Isko thoda aur highlight karenge. Yes. Now let's go for heat transfer by convection to heat transfer by conduction. So what is heat transfer by convection? H A delta T by this K F A delta T by L. A delta T is gone. This L will sit at the top. So H L by K F. And we got convective heat transfer to the conductive heat transfer. So let me remove this. We got convective heat transfer to the conductive heat transfer as H L by K of the fluid. So, but here students should understand the point. It is the thermal conductivity of fluid. So now Q convected to Q conducted is equal to HL by KF, where KF, F stands for thermal conductivity of the fluid, And this is known as Nusselt number. See the beauty of Nusselt number. So if someone asks you Nusselt number, don't say HL by K. It should be first physical, then mathematical. What is physical? It is the ratio of heat convected to the heat convected, conducted. Heat convected to the heat conducted. Abhi toh bataya tha. Just now I told you, which mode of heat transfer is faster, convection or conduction? Generally, convection is faster. When convection is faster, this is more than this. So obviously, this value will be greater than 1. So Nusselt number is generally greater than 1, greater than 1. For example, let us see the significance of Nusselt number. Matlab, agar Nusselt number hai, ek case mein 2 hai, aur dusre case mein maan lo, Nusselt number is 4. There are two cases. In one case, the Nusselt number is 2. In other case, it is 4. What is the physical significance of this? It is the ratio of convected to the conducted. Iska matlab hai, jab iska value zyada hai, if this value is more, that means my heat transfer by convection is faster. Matlab, convective effects are more. When convective effects are more, this value will be more. Iska matlab hai, out of these two, as the Nusselt number is more here, the convective effects are more in this fluid compared to this fluid. But the convection se bahut tez heat transfer ho raha isme compared to this. Now someone asks you, what if the Nusselt number is 1? When the Nusselt number is 1, iska matlab there is no effect of convection. Dono same ho gaye. Dono same. Iska matlab usme kya ho raha? Actually conduction hi ho raha hai. Means when Nusselt number is 1, in that fluid heat transfer is predominantly by what? Conduction only. Because Nusselt number 1 ka matlab hai, there is no effect of convection. There is no effect of convection. That's why in interviews they may be asking, what does Nusselt number of 1 signify? When Nusselt number is 1, it clearly shows that there are no effects of convection and the heat transfer is purely by conduction. So how to know the beauty of this, I'll give you a simple example so that you can further appreciate. But you should be very, very clear. Even bio number, when we discuss unsteady state conduction, it is also HL by K, but clear rehna bahut zaruri hai. In bio number, it is for the solid, which I'll be discussing later on. But in Nusselt number, it is HL by K of the fluid, K of the fluid, K of the fluid. Be clear, though they look similar, but there is a marked difference between both. So, hum ye baad mein batayenge, but and one of my students, IIT, he entered like PhD interview and they asked what is the difference between Nusselt number and bio number. And in fact, he got selected already because of this. And therefore, simple things are always complicated. It's for bio number, it is solid, and for Nusselt number, it is fluid. And be clear. So I'll give you a simple illustration so that you can appreciate the beauty of Nusselt number here. So if someone asks you, what is Nusselt number? In interviews, your answer should be, sir, it is the ratio of heat convected to the heat conducted. Higher the Nusselt number, more are the convective effects. If the Nusselt number is 1, in that fluid, the heat transfer is purely by conduction. Then you give mathematical equation HL by K. Stop for some time. Then he'll see like this, HL by K, fluid. Then they'll be happy. Asalikwa, what is Nusselt number? HL by K. Thoda der ruko, unke taraf dekhna. Aisa dekhenge aap. Arre, by number is also same. Then thoda muskura ke, aisa likho. F, fluid, maza aega. So now, have a look at this. I'll give you a simple example, my dear students. Dekho, let us take a fluid. This is at 60 degree, it is at 30. Same fluid, everything, all are absolutely same. All are absolutely same. There are four situations, absolutely same dimensions. Koi farak nahi hai. Same fluid, okay. 60, 30, 30, 60. Oh, 70, 40 and 40, 70. Temperatures. These are all degree centigrade temperatures. 1 second, 1 second. Fluid is absolutely same. Fluid is absolutely same. Clearly, it is said in the question. I'll show you the beauty of this Nusselt number. Clearly, he said in the question, the thermal conductivity is constant for all these temperature ranges. Thermal conductivity remains constant for all these temperature ranges. See, from 30 to 70 degree, the thermal conductivity is constant. He said, it is given. In this case, the heat transfer is given as 39 per unit area. In this case, the heat transfer is given as 26. In this case, the heat transfer is given as 42. And what is the heat transfer in this case? This is the question. See, now I use my concepts. 1 second, dekho. Isme kya ho raha hai? So it is higher, lower. So as the temperature is increasing, here the fluid temperature is increasing, density decreases. When density decreases, it moves up. So therefore it is convection. So here the temperature increases. So as the temperature increases, it will be there only. From there only it transfers heat. It is conduction. Isme kya ho raha? So when the lower temperature, lower surface is higher, so higher, lower, its temperature will be higher. When the temperature is higher, it will move. So therefore it is convection. Excellent. Now here it is at the top. It is at the top. So therefore already the temperature is high. Its density decreases. It has to move up, but it cannot move. Staying there only transfers. So therefore it is conduction. Stop. See the temperature difference. 60 minus 30, 60 minus 30, 40 minus 70 minus 40, 70 minus 40. In all the cases, temperature difference is 30 degrees centigrade. Stop. Stop. In this case, what type of heat transfer is taking place? Conduction. Conduction. Look at. And what is conductive heat transfer? Ka delta T by thickness L. And this thickness is absolutely same in all cases. So now tell me, my dear students, common sense. If the heat transfer is 42, from 70 to 40, 70 to 40, agar ye 42 hai, but it is by convection. If it is 70, 40, 40, 70, ulta hai. So if it is 42, what should be the heat transfer here? Ye convection hai, to fast hoga. But here it is conduction, it will be less. So it has to be less than 42. It has to be less than 42. How? Because 70, 40 is convection. So with convection, it is 42. But 70, 40 is conduction. With conduction, obviously, it will be slower than convection. So if it is 42, this has to be less than 42. Awesome. But now, this is less than 42. This is also less than 42. Be careful. But yahan pe kya ho raha hai? Conduction. Conduction. So therefore, it is also conduction. Clearly, you see, what is conductivity transfer? Ka delta T by L. What is the temperature difference? 70 minus. So conduction ka le raha hu main. I'm not taking this because it is convection. Conduction, conduction. Dekho, K. He clearly said K is same in all cases. Okay. Area, same hai area. What is the temperature difference? 70 minus 40, 60 minus 30, 30, 30, same. And thickness L is same. So therefore, I got this value as 26 here. So isme a value kitna hai? 26 hai. If it is 26 here, obviously it will be 26 only. No need to put pen on paper. Why? It has to be less than 42. Why? Because convective mode is faster than conductive mode. So therefore, so please understand clearly. So same will be here. Why? How did you get 26 here? Main aapko batata hun. How did I get 26 here? Is case ki bata raha hun. Look at. In this case, so conduction is equal to Ka delta T by L. But in last case also, it is conduction. Why? The lower one is 40, if I'm not wrong, and the upper one is 70. So it is conduction. So conduction. So what is K? I got in first case, I got this heat transfer. He has given it as 26. In both the case, again, in this case, what will be the equation? Same equation. So K mein koi fark nahi hai. Area mein koi fark nahi hai. Temperature difference is 60 minus 30. Difference here, not absolute values. 60 minus 30 is 30. 70 minus 40 is 30. Same. Thickness is same. When all are same, it has to be 26 only. Such is the beauty, my dear students. So if someone asks you in interviews, what is Nusselt number? And you should tell like this. Okay. So thank you, my dear students. I'll be coming up with many, many more such videos. And so if you want to contact KM, the numbers are 78931-90907. And the other one is 9000-770927. These are the contact numbers of KM. And hope to see you with many more videos. Thank you. God bless you.